Hey, welcome to Mike's Trains, and thanks for joining me for another video. This video is going to be the last in this series for painting this locomotive. We're going to do the decals this week, and I've already done one side, as you can see here. I think they came out pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. It's Brookfield Central. I added the numbers over here. They match the number boards that were originally on it. And we're going to go into, and I'm going to decal the other side just to show you how this got done for anybody who's wondering. So why don't we get started with that? In order to get this started, the first thing I had to do, and you probably should do, is I did a whole coat of clear gloss, because you need that shiny gloss coat for the decals to stick to properly. That's just, you know, you gotta have that. So I clear coated the whole locomotive, and then we start laying out the decals. Now the decals I'm using are microscale decals, and I bought a sheet of decals, and that looks like this. And you can see the letters I've already cut out to spell all that. It's just alphabets and numbers. They work well. So what I did was, when I cut out the other side, I did the lettering for both sides at once. I cut them both out. So what I have are a whole bunch of numbers and letters. So, oh, and the other thing you're going to need is a good sharp razor blade to do this. And what I have, what I end up with, is all of these little letters and numbers right here. So what I'm going to do is just put everything together and spell it out so that I can put them on the train in some kind of an order, and I'm not searching through an alphabet soup. Okay, so what I have are the sets of letters that I'm looking for. So those are right here. So they're all cut out, and that's exactly what I'm looking for. So all the letters are cut out and the numbers, so they're all just sitting there waiting. Now, to get on with how we're gonna do this, so now I've already said that we've clear coated this whole thing with gloss. I'm just using the roof here to hold this up at an angle that I can see. The other thing I have is I have this little tub here. This is something left over from takeout food that we had. And in this I have distilled water. Okay, and I use distilled water because I don't want minerals from the tap water to get into my paint here and under the decals and everything. Distilled water is clean. It's all cleared out for all of that. And then I have micro set, which is this. And this is what I'm going to use to prepare the surface on the locomotive and to let the decals set properly on top of the paint. And I'm going to apply that with a paintbrush. So I have a small paintbrush here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take this micro set and I'm just going to wet down the whole top. Now, I can't run these the same as I did the other side, because it would be backwards to what I'm doing to the other side. So I'm going to start with the smaller letters first, the central logo, and work my way from this way, just for my own sanity. So I'm going to be spelling things backwards, so I get the placement right. Alright, so now after this is sat for a few minutes, we're going to pull that out of the water, and we're going to set the letter on our paper towel. It only takes about 10 to 15 seconds in the water, by the way. Let that sit 10 to 15 seconds. And the directions for the decals will tell you the same. 10 to 15 seconds in the water, then you bring it over to your paper towel, and that's going to pull off the excess water. Let it sit on your towel for a little bit, and then you should be fine. So I'm just letting the towel absorb the extra excess water off of here. And put this over here. I'm going to take our brush and start sliding off the letter. And there it goes. I'm going to take the razor blade, take the corner, and just stab the little paper and pull it right out of there onto our paper towel. So, in looking at the other side, this is the panel. This door right here is what we want to line these letters with, where we want to start. So we're just going to brush this into place and straighten it up. Like that. And then we move on. And we do the A. And then we just keep working our way back until we spell out the whole word central. And then we start above it, and we're going to look on this side and see once central is spelled out on the other side, the I starts in Brookfield, or the D is right over the T and the R. So when we get over here, over the T and the R in central, we'll start the D here and work our way back. Yeah, and just so you know, sometimes they do go wrong. As you saw, I just the R rolled over on itself, and I have to cut out a new letter, so it happens. I think all in all, I might have wasted 3 or 4 letters out of the whole. I think there are 30 characters in the whole thing that I have to put in here. So 3 or 4, I don't think that's all that bad. But what you want to have is a good layer of this stuff here, because it'll let the decal float off of the paper, and that's really what you're looking for. Okay, so that's the whole thing. Now we'll just pat that down like the first one. Carefully not to move the letters. All right, so those are all on. Now I'm not going to do the numbers because, well, this is enough for video. This is all on here, and the next thing I want to do is we want to put away this micro set, and we want to take out micro saw, which is this right here. So now we're going to use this. And we're going to put this over the both sets of both the names there. Now this stuff is actually going to do something else for us. So you know you have the gaps for the doors, the hatch doors in here, and the letters go over those. Well, you and then this B sits on top of a hinge, so it's a little raised up. So we want to look that want that to have the look that it's actually down on the paint, like it's painted on. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of this stuff and we're just going to drop it right on top of all of our lettering. I'm not going to brush it, I'm just patting it down on. And what this is going to do is it's going to soften up the decals and let them flow down into all the inconsistencies in the surface. But things are kind of moving, so I got to be careful. And then we're going to let this sit. This needs to sit and dry for you want to let this sit, according the directions here say about 6 hours. When I did the other side, I actually let that sit overnight before I came back down, because I don't want my fingers when I'm working on this side to be messing with the other side. Okay, so that's now going to sit like that for, I don't know, I'll let this sit until tomorrow. And it's early now, so I mean, I got plenty of time. I could probably do it tonight. But once I put this next set of decals on, now those I don't need to put the micro saw, the red solution on here, because that's a flat surface. There's nothing, no contours that the decals need to go into. So those can just lay on there, and we'll put the blue micro set that we've been using for the whole thing just over that and let that dry. Now this whole thing will dry, like I said, 6 to 8 hours. I'll probably let it sit overnight just to make sure. Now once this is all dry, then I'm going to come back and I'm going to clear coat the whole thing again, and I'm probably going to do it in flat, like a flat clear over the whole thing, and then let that dry for a few hours. And then after that's dried, then we can go ahead with weathering and doing whatever else we want to do with the locomotive, as well as finish assembling it and putting all the parts back together. So that's going to be it for this video for this week. I hope I showed you something good and you liked what you saw. And if this is the first time you're seeing me, please subscribe to my channel. Love to have you along. Let me know what you think, if you like how it came out. I think it's okay. Obviously I think it could have been better, but I think it's been okay. So until next time, happy modeling.